Hello friends, welcome to lecture on object-oriented programming using C++. In today's video, we are going to discuss on Unit 4, pointers and polymorphism in C++. Weightage for this unit is 14 marks. Pointer operator. C++ provides two pointer operators. Address operator, that is ampersand, indirection operator, that is star. Pointer is a variable that contains address of another variable, or you can say that variable that contains the address of another variable is said to be point to other variable. The dot operator and arrow operators are used to reference individual members of classes, structures and unions. Address operator ampersand. Ampersand is a unary operator that returns memory address of its operand. For example, if a variable is an integer variable, then ampersand variable is its address. This operator has the same precedence and right to left associativity as the other unary operator. Indirection operator. The second operator is indirection operator, that is star. It is the complement of address operator, that is ampersand. It is unary operator that returns the value of the variable located at address specified by its operand. Polymorphism. Polymorphism means more than one function with the same name with different working. Polymorphism is considered as one of the important feature of object-oriented programming. The word polymorphism means having many forms. Typically, polymorphism occurs when there is a hierarchy of classes and they are related by inheritance. There are two types of polymorphism: compile-time polymorphism, which is called as static polymorphism, or early binding. Runtime polymorphism, it is called as dynamic polymorphism or late binding. This is a classification of types of polymorphism. Basically, polymorphism is classified into two types: compile time polymorphism, which is also called as static polymorphism or early binding, and second is runtime polymorphism, which is known as dynamic polymorphism or late binding. Example of compile time polymorphism is function overloading and operator overloading. The example of runtime polymorphism is virtual function. Difference between compile time polymorphism and runtime polymorphism. In compile time polymorphism, object is bound to function call at compile time. In runtime polymorphism, selection of appropriate function is done at runtime. In compile time polymorphism, functions to be called are known well before. In runtime polymorphism, functions to be called is unknown until appropriate selection is made. Compile time polymorphism does not require use of pointers to object. Runtime polymorphism requires use of pointers to object. In compile time polymorphism, function calls execution are faster. In runtime polymorphism, function calls execution are slower. Compile time polymorphism is implemented with operator overloading or function overloading. Runtime polymorphism is implemented with virtual function. In compile time polymorphism, memory will be allocated at compile time. In runtime polymorphism, memory will allocated at runtime. Compile time polymorphism is also known as static polymorphism or early binding. Runtime polymorphism is also known as late binding or dynamic polymorphism. Function overloading. More than one function with the same name with different signatures in a class or in a same scope is called as function overloading. The signature of function includes number of arguments, types of arguments, sequence of arguments. This is a sample code of function overloading. In this program, area function is called or written for four times. In first code, area function is implemented for calculating the area of circle. In this function, one parameter is passed for radius. In second definition, same name area function is written for calculation of area of a rectangle. In this function, two parameters are passed. In third example, the area function is written for calculating the area of rectangle. This is a sample example of function overloading. In this code, area function is written for four times. In first area function, area of a circle is calculated. In this function, single parameter is passed, that is integer r. In second area function, two parameters are passed, both are of integer type. This function is written for calculating the area of a rectangle. In third structure, area of a rectangle is again calculated, but input types are different. Two parameters passed in this function body. One data type is float and another is integer type. In fourth example, in fourth body, again area function is written for calculating the area of a rectangle. In this function, two parameters are passed. One parameter of integer type and another parameter of float data type. Means what? In function overloading, same function is written with same function name with different parameter list. Different statements are implemented under these functions.